That's what I was seeing last night in the crowd. You called it, dude. The squiggly light. I was seeing that last night in the crowd.
I'm telling you, we're just lucky we got up there last night.
Yeah, it was nice.
Was it? Yeah, I was there. It was at the top. Was it mountain.
Every night's a different trip, yeah.
Nothing's guaranteed, you know. You can tell, like I said, you know. We're just here tripping, listening.
Living.
We're here.
You too.
Yeah. We had your ginger snap.
Lovely return. Yeah. I'll come and visit with you again.
Thanks for coming by. Thanks for blessing us. She was at Jerry's last show.
Hey, hey.
She was at Jerry's last show. That's pretty cool in Chicago, huh?
I'm telling you, man, I wish we could all, you know, be vlogging, you know, like, you know, Joe Rogan, fucking get somebody on there and tell them, just tell them, you know, we should all be, you know, doing the fucking webcam, doing our stories and tales.
We are, that's why we're filming.
Everybody, you know, telling their stories. My buddy, just that he's really talented, impressive, he's doing a good job.
Today's my birthday, and we're like, fuck yeah, dude. And then he's like, and then as we're leaving, he's like, oh, I also have to tell you, my camera's been rolling this whole time.
Oh, good.
So I recorded this whole session, you know?
And
it was
epic.
We didn't know.
That's dope. Dope.
Like, think about podcasts at the end of the day, you're still, you know, like, put your mic up on the game, the energy.
The making up.
You watch football?
Yeah.
You know when they're mic'd up, it's just mic'd up.
Thank you to everyone watching.
Deacon Jones and all the other and you know, you start off your first gigs at Coliseum, but guess what? Everything's downhill after that. That building out of fucking
one hour.
Stadium tours like a dog in the town of
five.
I did own the Coliseum and tore up all the sod and throw it. Body count, popular album.
This is epic, fellas. I feel very blessed to be here with you guys. And really good vibe, good energy, just incredible night. Shut my mouth now and that's it. Warmer than last night, too. Yeah. Just for a warmer. A little warmer. Yeah.
Sasquatch.
It's epic, huh?
Thought about that. Dude, I was laying in bed fucking at 5:30 in the morning when I got home. I was fucking laughing my ass off. Thought I can't go to sleep. I'm laughing.
You're right, though, about like the kid is born.
Just fucking, right, just bit your fucking neck from behind. Right? So I kept looking behind me. That's a real hypnotic fucking jam with that guy. You got really everybody in fucking.
Dude, last night.
Or no,
Friday night.
We could invite everybody to this place.
The space was intense. Like techno shit. It was crazy.
Yeah.
And I, at the time, I'm like, dude, is this show? Because people were walking out, they're kind of heavy and like.
That's where it was last night. I guess the people were doing a good fucking show.
To this day, that we should give you balloons there,
so
yeah.
Last night too, we're
low key.
Streaming out. And I was like, what? Is it over? It's like a bailing.
Yeah, it was weird.
Keyboard. And it sounded like fucking Nicky got up there and just started doing his fucking percussion solo.
That was good music after.
So,
after party.
So, how do you show Hog Farm? Hog Farm?
Yeah, maybe babies.
Right, so I got my weights in the Hog Farm.
Really?
Yeah, so like
You blessing yourself, Rasta?
You know, you work daily.
Blessing of the Rasta. It's a shotgun shot.
It's an SCI.
Yeah. UFO plane?
It's a chain of course, and if you're the Kate Wolfman festival. Kate Wolf is dope. I love that festival, bro. That festival is the best.
It's great.
You know, Wavy Gravy and Bob Barsotti.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of
so
that.
So Bob Barsotti is the one that actually owns it. And Bob Barsotti was really grand right-hand man. So he's the one that designed the shoreline. You know the shoreline with the footing, steal your face part of it, right?
Yeah, I worked security for Bill Graham right before he died.
Okay, and we all know. Okay, so I'm a... So I didn't fucking Nighthawk shit. But it was all about the Billy Graham, you know, we're chilling, dude. Like, we're not being a dick. So it's funny, yeah, Billy Graham security, that's what I did in festivities. That was the way when I did security, it was like this Billy Graham way. And it was like, we kick it, bro. All we're doing is, and the way you described me, it was like, yo, out of 1,000 people, there's one dude that wants to fuck it up for everybody. Just get rid of the one guy. That's it. You know, and like, wait until everybody's got the shiny thing, which is the show happening, and then fucking take the guy out the back, just handle the shit.
Oh yeah, Bill Graham, I swear still with the sex on
my head.
Don't be that guy, he said. Don't be that guy.
My mom was
walking
around
the phone, I fucking came up to me, and I go, oh, Mr. Graham, it's such an honor to tell you. Just put us out there on this phone. Right after Stevie Ray died in the plane crash.
Oh.
Fucking he died in the helicopter crash. And they're calling me going, hey, Stevie Ray was dying. And I saw the front page of the fucking LA Times. There's Bill Graham's helicopter up on the fucking high frequency.
Cables. I remember that,
up there. You know,
the cables were still there.
Yeah, but he was tied up there in Hong Kong. I was like, oh my God, no, I was just in the hotel.
Like you said, I'm in the Bay Area. So when it happened, you know,
everybody was fucking crazy.
So I didn't.
Chased us out of one spot, and we got this
brother.
beam's breaking off up there. Is it breaking up?
So dude, what happened is that summer I just ended up staying after the channel first, I just stayed in the hog farm for the summer. Without asking, like, it was an easy thing, I just ended up staying there. And I still worked all the other festies, but after they were done, I came back to the hog farm. That's where I stayed. And weekends I even told my friends, I was talking to my friend, oh, my time I was like, I have to disappear. Oh, and my brother died. Also, he brought, the thing about Bob is he, from what I understand, the Who and the drinks are.
Exactly. Halloween 2021 started.
I taught him how to make those jackets.
English 1A, right?
He's killing us.
English 1A. In college
of the 60s. Proud of you, Super. Thank you for all the wisdom, Rasta.
That's true. My guy's name is Charles Uncle first. Super, like, super liberal fucking movie. You know? And, I'm not a liberal either, so when I say that, either way, he said it was the first day, and English 1A, it's like English 101, like you have to take this class in college. Okay, it's your English requirement. And he says, this is going around, like, what's your name? Like, we all know that you have to take this class. Like, I'm not going to ask you why you're taking the class, but you're like, are you too excited about literature or whatever? Like, speak up. And it was the whole thing, like, you know, like, I've done this, this, and this, like, I need to write a book. And finally, he's like, you know what, I appreciate that fact, but just remember, like, you're on the beginning of your life, you're on the
Rhinestone Cowboy. Rhinestone Cowboy. Yeah. I'm just gonna fuck the world and stuff.
Yeah. Anyways, he said, remember, you're in the front end of everything. It's like, so if you ever get the need to feel like you need to write a book, don't. Because if your life is that interesting, somebody's gonna write a book about it.
I got four books in my head.
There you go.
It was more of an autobiographical, like a metaphor.
I got four books in my head on writing.
It's true, though.
He said, don't. But it was more, and then he alluded, it turned into like, wait until you're fucking 70, dude.
I put them off because most of the people I'm writing about are still alive. I don't want to get sued. I don't really want to be talking about it. It's a pretty,
going off here.
Pretty fucking raw ass stories.
We're going for it here.
Stone Cowboy, yeah, it's Stone Cowboy. Get a close up on
it. So I'm Stone Cowboy in the night. Space Cowboy. Living the dream. Trip at a time.
Oh, it looks like a fucking fantasy land game. It looks like, yeah, Super Mario.